Hi everyone, my name is Nitin, and today we are here again with one of our another alumni who is from the valuation stream, and we are going to talk about his journey and a knowledge sharing part in terms of valuation. Here I present you Mr. Hari Krishna. He's a graduate from RICS School of Built Environment, 2017 graduate from the course Real Estate, REUI. Welcome on our discussion, Hari.
Thank you, Mr. Nitin.
So, Hari, before we start, could you please give us a little background and, you know, brief introduction about yourself?
So, hi, everyone. Actually, my name is Hari Krishna. I passed out my bachelor's in civil engineering in the year 2014. After that, I did work in the field of quantity surveying and valuation for 1 year. And then immediately joined RICS school. And I passed out in the year 2017 with a gold medal. And since 2017 up to now, I have been working in the field of valuation with an organization named SVE Valuation and Advisory LLP, which is based out of South India. So this is about myself.
Sure, thank you very much for that kind of introduction. And while you have brought out your core niche experience and evaluation, we will be using this time use your knowledge and experience to be able to share it with our alumni and students so that they can learn it from you and your experience. So while you have brought it out, could you please actually introduce valuation to us, because that's a very demanding area or a field of people are really intended to it, to be able to, make their career in this field. So introduce valuation to us.
Yeah, sure. So valuation is one such field which is critical for everything in the economy. It forms a backbone, I would say. So if the valuation is relied upon and a decision is taken, then the decision would be wiser, rather than taking a decision without any background and without any analysis. So valuation is universally applicable in all fields, be it real estate, securities and finance, or maybe industrial assets. Everywhere valuation is, it's a must. It forms a pivot point, I would rather say. So valuation, it is gaining momentum. It has gained momentum during the last one decade. Government has rolled out many policies, be it the Insolvency and Bankruptcy Code and many others. So there are dedicated bodies like Insolvency and Bankruptcy Board of India, etc. And organizations like IVS, RICS, they have come up with a lot of standards. So to bring a sense of parity in the field of valuation. So valuation is gaining momentum. All this while it has been an unorganized field. Now it is going towards maturity and it is becoming more organized, I would say that.
Right, and with this being more organized, more job opportunities and career opportunities would flow in.
Yes.
So how many, how would the opportunities or the job roles would look like? So for someone who is graduating out from School of Built Environment, or probably who might be looking at making a career, what all the different job roles they might be looking at, or how many job roles or different fields in evaluation is waiting for them?
Oh, well, the number of opportunities, there is a sea of opportunities in the field of valuation. If you look at the statistics, the type of population in India, it is about 130 plus crores, but the number of actual number of available valuers, well, you guess the number of figure, how many people are available in the field of valuation? What is the number? Just take a guess.
100,000?
Less than that, actually. So it is less than around 10,000 professionals that are there. So imagine, for a population of 130 plus crores, you have just 10,000 valuers or valuation professionals, I would say, that are available today in the country. And there is a dearth or a shortage for quality professionals who can help individuals in making decisions, investing decisions, getting capital from a bank or in the form of a loan, or raising capital from the markets in the form of equity. Everything requires valuation. So any person who is passing out from professional course, be it MBA or bachelor's in engineering or architecture, whatever be it, there is an opening and there is always a welcome call everywhere in the field of valuation. How? Right from the groundwork up to the analysis and up to the decision making, everywhere different professionals with different competencies are involved. So there is a lot of opportunities out there available if you can actually, one, the first point, if you can get educated with the right knowledge, and number two, if you have dedication. These two, when you have, valuation is the field to be. And this is the field that is going to outshine all the professions, by this I say accounting or, the other financial planning, etc., which have their own set of organized systems. So valuation is heading towards that direction. And any person entering into this field, this is the right time to be in.
Rightly brought out. And again, it is not just the real estate physical assets. There is the intellectual property and other fields wherein the valuation might be required. And these professionals would have a bright career or future ahead when they get into this field. So with that, what are the key skills and competencies one must brush up or bring into their skill set to be able to do well in this field of a career?
Yeah. So firstly, valuation, one has to have the first factor I would say is idea of the markets. Be it if you are in real estate valuations, you should know real estate markets well. What are the types of transactions that are happening? What is the type of yield at which places are getting leased at? Who are the big players? What are the big deals that have happened, etc.? And what are the government policies, be it RERA, GST, what are their impacts? And what is the monetary policy doing, RBI, repo rates, etc.? So first thing is knowledge, that is both general knowledge as well as the subject knowledge. Second one is dedication to valuation. So valuation, since it is a niche subject, and many people, there are situations when you have to educate your customers before they accepting your work. So certain people would not know what they want to ask from you. So in such situations, you have to be knowledgeable enough to educate your customer or educate your client and submit your work. The third part I would say is to be resilient. So resilient in the sense, there are times, certain decisions may go wrong or may go right. You should not, get shaken off. You should trust the process and keep moving ahead in the path. So, and one more thing is, you have to keep yourself upgrading and updating every day. So these are the main skills, I would say, in the valuation field.
Thanks, and rightly brought out. And apart from that, how valuable would be a knowledge of finance or capital market or, doing, analytics or working with balance sheets? Are they equally important as well?
Yes, certainly. So now if you say you have a case in time where you are called upon to value the entire portfolio of a company, say a REIT. So a REIT works, what is REIT, right? Real Estate Investment Trust. So these REITs are an organized instruments of real estate which are listed in the stock market. And suppose you get an opportunity to work, not only land and building and plant and machinery, you should certainly know how to crunch the balance sheets, how to analyze the numbers, and put things at the right place so that you are making a good impression with everyone, be it SEBI or be it your clients, board of directors, etc. So having financial knowledge is always a plus point, and of course you will be learning it in the MBA program. So that is the best thing, one of the best things to happen. And apart from that, there will be always, you know, reliance on the standards, valuation standards, be it accounting standards, valuation standards. All these will actually protect the professional, you know, in case something goes wrong. You can always rely upon the standards and show that your process was right. So valuation is more process oriented. So markets can fluctuate. Today there is a boom, tomorrow there is a bust. I mean, there is a fall. So valuer, what I mean to say is the valuation, the numbers can go wrong, but the process will always protect you. So having the right process in place through the right knowledge and with, with shelter of the right standards, that will make you a successful valuation professional, I would say.
Right. And again, with this kind of, knowledge and the curriculum, knowledge or the experience, the past experience that you may had, could you also talk about or probably, take us through your day at work? And in terms of, evaluation, what all sort of activities that you perform on a daily basis? While you have already, brought it out that, there is a lot of research work which is required. You might be, reading a lot of things, then trying to implement it in the work and certain, analytics and things like that you might be doing. So take us through a day of work.
So I will talk about the typical day of work from the perspective of a beginner. So as you go on the top of ladder, it will be more of administrative work. But when you set your foot into this field as a beginner, you will have to go to the site visit. So at the site visit, you will have to look at everything with a hawk's eye, with a sharp eye, with attention to minutest details. So once you have done the site visit, then you will talk to different stakeholders of real estate, such as brokers, such as different owners, agents, etc. And then after that, you come back to the office, you may want to prepare the valuation report or make a valuation research before getting into the report part, taking the inputs from the different sources. So all these things form a major part of a valuation professional as a typical day.
Well, that's a lot of thing that, you are interacting with people, you are trying to read the minds, it's a human behavior and psychology is in place. You are reading a lot basis, the data and information available online. You mentioned standards, policies, and certain regulations which are in play. There is a financial background information which might be required once you are doing it. And finally, you are preparing a report. Basis which certain financial transactions will be done. So again, it's a huge responsibility when it comes to a work. So certainly. Thank you for sharing all these details. And one last question is on the advice. What will be your advice for a person who would want to start a career in valuation, or who is about to finish his course in this field and is about to begin his career journey?
So advice to any person who wants to come into valuation is, first point is you have to know whether you want to really get into valuation, because I have spoken about what are the challenges over there, because you have a lot of responsibilities coming upon your shoulder. Second one is you will have to have a lot of dedication towards what you are doing. Dedication in the sense, valuation tests your patience a lot. So you have to be patient enough to stick to what you are doing. And the third one is, continuously you have to be upgrading your knowledge and get a sense of what the market is doing and what is happening in the market. And the fourth one is, valuation, if you are enjoying it, this is the place you want to be in. So these are the advices.
Sure, thank you very much for sharing that, a wonderful piece of information. And I'm sure our viewers will be, you know, benefiting a lot from this particular piece of information. So thank you for being with us today, and we'll continue working with you and other alumni to be able to, you know, use their knowledge and journey so that our students and alumni can benefit from it. Thank you so much for being with us today.
Thank you. Thank you so much.